Oh my gosh, I am so sorry to keep you guys waiting. Oh my gosh. Hi, it's my birthday and Brooke's going live and it's my birthday. I mean, what the fuck is going on? There's a party going on right here. It's celebration. What's going on over there? Why is he sulking? And Jindy, thank you for sending me those super chats. Thank you, thank you, thank you. I mean, Jules had a meltdown today. John's having a meltdown today. What the fuck is y'all's problem? What is y'all's problem? Oh my God, I just went outside and I'm best friends with the landlord, and he comes over for dinner, but he didn't even tell me that they were moving and they just came. Shut the grift. Grift and grift and grift. Give me the beat, boys, and free my soul. You're a grifter. It's not gonna look good. You have been over there. He has been over there bitching. How does he know he's even gonna come over here and talk about his birthday? Jules is all worried about the money. Oh, the money. Shut the fuck up, Jules. You only worry about money like that because you don't have a job. And grift away. Grift. Grift. I'm thinking of all kinds of good songs. Grift, baby, grift. Thank you, sweets. Happy Friday. Thank you for the super chat. Jules, you're so worried. So worried. And look what worried about my pockets get you. Thank you, Lauren Marie. Thank you, Cree. I mean, my God, I hadn't even gone live. Thank y'all so much in honor of his birthday. Look at my chat making it rain for John's birthday. Happy birthday, John. I'm glad we could all come together today to celebrate your special day together. Since you've literally ruined your whole birthday party, worried about me and going live. Why can't you just ignore me? Why? Why can't you just ignore me and have a good birthday? My Lord. I mean, goodness gracious, let me think here. I mean, it's Friday, so let's shall we? Let's see. No. Let me see. Let's do it right. Oh my gosh, new member Six Gun Sweetie, and don't say so much. Thank you for the $10. Oh my gosh, hi everybody coming in. Hey Amy. Oh my gosh, E11 and Sam Marks. Thank y'all for the super chats. Y'all are freaking making it rain up in here. Happy birthday, John. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to John Yates, the famous celebrity blogger with all the connections ever. Happy birthday to you.
You can't walrus. You can't walrus. You can't walrus. Can't walrus.
The all-powerful Oz. Y'all, thank y'all for real for the super chats. I can't even keep up. Thank y'all. Don't say so much. Lauren, let me just go through them real quick. Jindy, thank you. Sweets and Beyond. Lauren Marie, Cree, Jody B, Cats Rule, Coochie Pooda, Sam Marks, E11, Six Gun Sweetie. Don't say much. And Lauren Marie again. Thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you. But look, let me tell y'all how this came to be. Jules is like, she just wants money. She just wants money. He is a... This wasn't even my fucking idea, bitch. No. You know, Mother Teresa might be a fucking flip-flopping hater ass. And Mother Teresa, you didn't call me and our group mob mentality. You called a whole nother group of people that. So move along. But at least she's got a little bit of snap still left in her for her old gal, because she knew exactly what I was going for, and I got it. And then, just because y'all are so worried about my fucking money, thinking y'all can't let me make money because I make my own money elsewhere, then y'all are going to see, this is what happens when you fucking worry about my shit. I simply did it just to be a troll. And John's like, I haven't even been talking about her. Oh my gosh, Cats Rolling, thank you for the membership. Oh my gosh. We're going to just one more time for John. We haven't seen this in a long time anyway.
Elevate scrotum with a towel. While laying down, which I've been doing. Elevate scrotum with a towel. Roll while laying down, which I've been doing.
Elevate scrotum with a towel. Elevate scrotum with a towel.
Scrotum, scrotum, scrotum. Scrotum, scrotum, scrotum. Elevate scrotum with a towel. Roll while laying down, which I've been doing.
That's right, Nurse Jen. And thank you. Congrats, Wet Sock, on a great video today. Maybe somebody needs to pass that little clip to Wet Sock so he can utilize it in his videos. Wouldn't that be something? Wouldn't that be something? Thank y'all so much. Oh my God, Lauren Marie, another one. And another one. And another one. Y'all, thank y'all. And John, you didn't even say thank you for like the first $200 you got in your stream. Ugh, you're so just, you just expect.
You know it ain't no stopping all the dogs I'm dropping. It's Friday night, so everything is popping. I got stainless spin on the head, so let the games begin. Yakety yak, don't talk back or a song. Calling up Earl on the car phone. Mac 10 just got out of court, bumming through the hood in the super sport, bumping too short. 18 got the rear view mirrors vibrating, and deep dish dating. You know how we do it, ain't nothing to it but the floss. Overcrowding, Harrison Ross, cause if you fuck with us, we need stars. Out of G-Ride cars, living like stars. Might hit the highway on the Vegas run, fool, cause it's Friday.
Oh yeah, throw your neighborhood in the air. If you don't care, oh yeah, throw your neighborhood in the air.
I mean, and furthermore, thank you so much, Sativa Toast. Troll Game is strong. I mean, golly, over there crying. E11 party. Thank you again, Lauren Marie. Thank you so much. So much. Oh, I bet she was so mad. And Jules just, I heard Jules say, she just wants to go over there and have a super chat fight. What the fuck is that? Is that something that you have in your head, Jules? Me and Terry Lynn didn't get in a fight because of that. You don't know what you're talking about. I later found out it was because of a disagreement that she and I had, because Dia told us we can't go live about CWA. We've talked about it since. I thought it was about Super Chats, but we've talked about it since. Anyway, look at what you did. Look at what you did. Look, hi, everybody coming in. Look at what you did, dummy. But then she also just said, she wants to say, oh, let's make them mad and send me Super Chats. That's your friend Siwa, okay? Okay, that is your friend Siwa. That is not me. That is, and let's also, I'm going to be all over the place. I've had so many thoughts in my head. I'm so glad I got to watch the first hour of that shit show, party, air quotes, because, John, you just quit YouTube the other night after you got a brand new computer. You've also been mentioning moving for I don't know how long. I don't know how long. So, like, now, like, your subs have got to be, my God, like, they just bought you a computer, and now you're like, and now guess what? Now guess what, guys? Now I don't have any place to live. Suddenly. And then his whole chat is over there. Oh, yeah, I'm taking requests. It's a party. But I do want to play a little bit of the Bees. Like, none of your business. And by the way, she is over there pissing John right off, doing what she always does, making it about her. Look at me. I'm all these filters. Look at me. You're pissing him off, Jules. I mean, like, maybe you, can you not read the room or read your friends? Like, and PMR, thank you. Did I say thank you to you? And we also got to talk about Geneva. My God, PMR dropped the freaking mic, and so did Daddy yesterday in my comment section. Geneva.
And she's over there. I didn't even do anything.
Yeah, you did. And it's all in nice, neat little paragraph form right there on my community tab of what exactly you did. So if you need to refresh your memory, I mean, Geneva, you literally got caught saying you were in the hospital and you got a cat meowing in the background. What? Can't forget about the $2 trash box hooker. Oh, my gosh. Absolutely. Thank you so much.
You can't walrus.
Oh, well, the thing is John, don't ever play a game of poker, boo-boo, because you don't got no poker face. You can't even sit there and skin and grin. You're sitting there rolling your eyes, putting your hand on your face. Oh, yeah. I heard him sitting there trashing E11. She is beautiful. John, why do you got to trash all the women over here? What kind of man are you? Creed, thank you so much. Walrus. Almost 2 years. Oh my goodness. It was a filter, John. He literally thinks that those were Patrick. But anyway, what? Did he think those were your eyebrows? That's what I don't understand. Cooch, anybody's welcome to come up. Come on up. Anybody want to come up? Cooch, you want to put on for the birthday boy? You want to be the birthday boy? And I think other people have some props. Anyone? Bueller? Let's listen to a little bit of Jules really quickly. Because, girl, like, butt out. Like, mind business. And that is us. So let me get back to how this all originated. It was not even... Like, it was literally said in chat, well, you've done a birthday for Siwa and Amber. Might as well do one for John. I was like, holy shit. It didn't even cross my mind. It didn't even cross my mind. All I wanted to do was, like, honestly, at this point in the game, when are folks going to just rise above it? If I just knew if that were me, I'd be like, there'd be no way I would let that even bother. I'd be like, what are you talking about? I don't even know who is Brooke who. Like, who's Jules? Who's Brooke? Who's Blake? Who the fuck? I don't want cops called on his birthday. He would, if I mask up. Yeah, probably. Oh, my God. Thank you. Don't say much. My Lord and Jindy, thank you. My God, can we get a John video? Which John video, Jindy? You want the other one? I've been playing that one. Oh, my gosh. Thank you. I'm going to be like, Steve, do you want a video? Do you want my firstborn? Do you want a quarter to a blood? Thank you. Don't say much. Show much. No, but thank you for real, both of you. Everybody, thank y'all so much. Say hi, Jason.
Hey.
There's Jason. Thank you. Okay, you missed the scrotum. We'll do it again.
You wanna...
scrotum with a towel roll while laying down, which I'm doing.
Elevate scrotum with a towel. Elevate scrotum with a towel.
Scrotum, scrotum, scrotum. Scrotum, scrotum, scrotum. Elevate scrotum with a towel roll while laying down, which I've been doing.
Which I've been, I'm missing old Amber. I wonder which one of these sock accounts is,
I am the big shot. You ain't got fucking dick. I am the big shot.
Happy birthday, John. I hope you're having a great day. I really do. You deserve it. I mean, like, after all, like you said, you haven't spoken about me long. You just totally violated. Thank you for being a member for 11 months, Napa. And thank you for that clip, E11. Hello, Cynthia Burke. It's been a while. Oh, my gosh. Oh, my gosh. But it's your birthday, John. And we're here to celebrate you, honestly. We are. Let's see here. But at least you had a fangirl to fluff for you before you're live. Cool. Let's see what the all-knowing B has to say. Boop. Earlier about my plans that honestly didn't even cross my mind. But what did cross my mind is, how are you going to quit after you get a computer and then not do a birthday stream on your birthday and then come back, you know, 2 days later and grift again?
People, when they decide to have a party themselves, they decide to dress up as the people they hate so that they can grift for money. So we all know that John's birthday was a couple days ago and we didn't celebrate it on that day. And we all know that this evening is going to be John's birthday celebration. Now, who do we see that's going live at the same time? And the reason why
dun, da, da, da.
Is because she's going to do it to solicit super chats.
I didn't solicit shit. I did not. I don't even got a scrolling banner. I didn't say nothing about stuff is appreciated and never expected. I didn't do any of that. Y'all, that was voluntary, bitch. And it was because everybody heard you throwing a fit and saw John doing the same.
She's going live at the same time because this is the way she thinks she can solicit.
I actually was running very late, very, and I do apologize, guys. And that's why I didn't do the roll call, because I literally already, you know, told Jason, hey, is it cool if I like literally like just come inside and go live? Yeah, it's fine. Anyway. I literally came in here as quick as I could. I didn't solicit shit, and I was very late. But so why in the interim, before I went live, did you just act like, why was my live in my chat before I was even in the live? Why was that your topic of conversation on your birthday party? Oh my God, stop. Please make him stop, Cooch, because the super chat monster is vicious. He is vicious. I'm making him do it. Go, super chat monster, go. What the fuck is wrong with you? Y'all are counting chickens before they're freaking even hatched over there. And then look what you did.
Super chats. Can you imagine somebody being that sad and pathetic that they want to go live at the exact same time because they want, what they want to do is they're like, oh, send me super chats and it's going to make them really mad. That's what she wants to do. So anybody that falls for that.
That's what Siwa does. I mean, right there. Y'all know that meme of Bart Simpson, like fading away back into the bushes. Literally, that was Siwa after Jules said that. That's probably why she didn't go into her chat. Oh my God, thank you for the memberships, Kelly.
You can't walrus. You can't walrus. You can't walrus. You can't walrus.
Thank you, Lauren Marie. That super chat monster is gonna get ya. It's coming to get ya. Oh my God.
That reminds me of the song. I don't know why, but anyway, we don't have to play it. Well, we have to because it's funny. One that I'll get my shit taken down for. I better just. But thank you. And oh my gosh, Sweets and Beyond, another super chat. What monster? Go get a monster. I'm sure. What the fuck? That's how your brain operates, Jules, because you're the one that's always thinking about how you're going to get money. This is a great supplement, especially during, you know, expensive events that go on in our lives. It's a great way to be like, you know, wow, I can do this and earn an supplemental income to pay for my supplemental expenses. Paz, thank you for being a member for 2 months. Oh my gosh. And Cat's Rule, another one. I wasn't even down here. And Kelly, another one. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, John. I'm just telling you, happy birthday. Thank you, Kelly, for John's birthday. Another $10. My gosh. Y'all are just so, I'm so sorry I'm twisting y'all's up. Y'all need to take some ibuprofen because I'm twisting your arms so hard. About what, Kiki? Oh, I love it too, but I bet you I would get stroke, but I wonder if it's like, and that means that shit will get taken down. Like down. Fucks it. I just feel like the older artists get taken down. Like the more classic, the song, I don't know. The older stuff gets taken down. I feel like I could play Taylor Swift and not getting taken down. Look what you made me do. Look what, that's what I want to play. That's what I want to play. Because look what you made them do, Jules, because you're so fucking jealous and bitter and like obsessed. Oh, that's a good one. I'll play Taylor next. But seriously, for real.
And I was like, why are you so obsessed with me?
Thank you, Iris.
MC. All up in the block, saying we met at the bar. When I don't even know you are. Saying we up in your house, saying I'm up in your car. But you in LA, and I'm out at your mates. I'm up in the A, you so, so lame. And no one here even mentions your name. It must be the weird. It must be the ear. Cause you be poppin', heard you get it poppin'. Oh, oh, oh. Why you so obsessed with me? Boy, I wanna know. Lying that you're sexing me when everybody knows. It's clear that you're upset with me. Oh, finally found a girl that you couldn't impress. Last man on the earth still couldn't get this. You're delusional, you're delusional. Boy, you're losing your mind. It's confusing, you're confused, you know. Why you wasting your time? Got you all fired up with your Napoleon complex. See it right through you like you're bathing in Windex. Boy, why you so obsessed with me?
You on your job, you hating hard. Ain't gon' feed you, I'ma let you stop. Bursting for air, I'm in a vision. You
out of breath, hope you ain't waiting, telling the world how much you miss me. But we never were, so why are you tripping? You a mom and pop, I'm a corporation. I'm the press conference, you a conversation. Oh, 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 oh. Why you so obsessed with me? And boy, I wanna know, lying that you're sexing me when everybody knows. It's clear that you're upset with me. Oh, funny kind of girl that you couldn't impress. Last man on the earth still couldn't get this. You're delusional.
That bullshit tonight, you're dumb. You're either dumb or you've got that much hate in your belly. Because, yeah, is the roof damaged again?
Oh, my God. The roof. The roof. The roof is on fire. I ain't telling this story no more because you already know what the truth is. You're stupid. I don't expect you to understand. Go talk to your landlord. No shade to people with landlords. I'm just saying, motherfucker, when you don't know what you're talking about, shut the entire fuck up. Last time I checked, you never owned a house. Thank you, Lisa Dempsey. Thank you, Cats Rule again. Oh, my God. You guys. Thank you so much. You know how much kitty litter this would buy if I needed it to be funded by my subs like Jules does? Do y'all know how much this would buy? Thank you.
Nobody's made any more money, more money, I should say, on Super Chats and whatnot than that bitch. But because it's somebody's birthday party today, she decides she's going to go live.
Have you fucking really counted to make that statement? Have you counted to make that statement? I'm just wondering. I mean, weren't you the one that had the time that you had you wanted to get 100 Super Chats in one stream and you did? Remember that, Jules? Why are you counting my money? Y'all are all still hung up on something that happened almost a year ago. Not that I'm not still forever grateful. Like, I will never forget that shit ever. 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 Getting back together. It's another good song. But I will never. Y'all will never forget that shit. I am so sorry. It burned y'all's ass that much. But here we are.
She can say, everybody, get him really mad and send me lots of money. When actually it's send me a lot of money because her husband is getting ready to tell her she needs to hang it up unless she starts making money.
He's never once told me that. He never told me,
you better hang it up. You better start making some money.
He said, if you're going to spend time doing something, make sure you're not wasting your time like I was wasting on Instagram. I'm not, you know, spending a lot of time on something and yielding no benefit from it. It was a more like, it wasn't he said. To me, it was more palatable for me to be like, hey, I'm going to go live if I'm having something to show for it, except for spending, you know, the time that I'm live away from him. Or, like I said, though, I usually try to do this shit for the most part during the day, as y'all all well know by now. With the exception of maybe one night every now and then, especially. But no, he never told me that. It was just like anybody that's married would know that unless it's like going to the gym or like another kind of hobby, playing tennis, you know, something that's good for your health, you're getting something out of that when you're, you know, taking time away. Or, you know, but if you're just fucking around on a computer when you're married, and spending time doing this, yeah, it's a lot more easier for, you know, him to say, sure, that's no problem, like he did tonight. It's no problem. I go when I can. But anyway, I digress. Oh, that's all they do. And then the part of John's live where they're like, I just can't believe they just lie. And I'm going, what the fuck are you talking about? John, you just told everybody the other night that I sent nudes to all the cast members in 90 Day Fiance. No proof. And you're never going to see it. Because guess what, guys? Spoiler alert. It never happened. And then he said, I've sent corn to them all. Corn. Yeah, I sent them all corn too. Yep. I'm the 90 Day Fiance corn supplier, according to John Yates, Esquire, fucking celebrity blogger. Okay.
All y'all are to her are a dollar sign. Yeah, tell us you have no.
Actually, all everybody is to you, Jules, because you're the one that has no choice but to fucking befriend people and be nice and control yourself, more importantly, because anybody that's anybody that was on Instagram knows that she was throwing tantrums at least once a week. At least once a week. Oh my God, 5 90-day on blast memberships. What in the what? What in the what? Like Jewel says, what in the what? Thank you so much. Don't say much. Hello, Muzz. Oh my God. What in the what? Hi, guys. It's my birthday. And I have a surprise for sale sign on my house. Like somebody, hey, fucking Alexa, play Sarah McLachlan. Like, come on. Some more scrotum. Oh, and that's another lie that I sent Cody's unmentionables around to people. Never, not once did I. Lies upon lies. And they're over there going, I can't believe they just lie. Who? About what? Oh my gosh, you know what? That's gonna be a new thing. We could do interactive live streams. Like when I want y'all to get a certain sentiment, instead of playing it here, oh my gosh, I could just activate all of your Alexas and give you the exact ambiance in like stereo. That would be a perk. Maybe I could start doing that. How creative is that, y'all? She doesn't do anything. She doesn't even have emojis. The nerve. I do too. They're just not like up to my standards either. But unfortunately, since I have children, a household, pets, and a whole ass job and another job, I would love to be a better graphic designer, but I don't have all fucking day and half the night to spend on Canva fucking around and clicking, click, click, clicking like you.
Life on a Friday night without telling us.
What kind of a life does a fucking 43-year-old mother have on a Friday night anyway? I'm not like, we're not like going out to the club and shit like that. What are you, huh? What exactly kind of, what? Oh, how about you, friend? Sitting at home behind a bee filter on a Friday night. Yeah, can you find a clown filter, please? I need you to find a clown. You need to wear a filter. Because you are making fun of me, a mother that's married, for not going out on a Friday night. When you're single, no kids, nothing, no strings, nothing. Yeah, I enjoy quiet nights at home, ma'am. You, on the other hand, have a whole ass life to live out there. You said you had one, a new life that you'll never tell anybody about. Prove it, liar.
She made a killing last year when she did a Siwa birthday extravaganza, because this is what her jam is. Is she wants to do this because, at the same, this is the immaturity level.
Right. She made a whole emoji calling it, it had an A on it, saying that was Amzi. Like, Jules, at least she gets on camera. At least Amzi's proud enough of her body to do TikToks and to dance and to show her fucking face. I don't give a shit if you love her or hate her. Jules, I said it once, I'll say it again, is ducking like a vampire that's seeing fucking sunlight when she turned her camera on. Okay? Meanwhile, Amzi, the way she looks, she looks just fine. Rude. If I was really rude like you, I'd put up a picture of your arms. But I'm not, so I won't. Won't. Yeah. And how many times, Laura Marie, thank you very much. How many times has she gone live? And I know her. And I know her mentality. And she already thinks, like, I'm going to go live against so-and-so to pull their views. And John, as in anybody, knows, they all know that she does this. So why won't I already be in the head of this bee and know exactly what she's thinking? And I hate that I've broken the freaking mold today on, well, it is John's birthday. So it is John's birthday. So it's a time to celebrate and let loose. It's Good Friday, guys. It is Good Friday. So we have to be over here telling the truth. We can't let these liars sit over there and lie. And he says he has a rosary. Oh my gosh. Thank you so much for my nails and hair extensions. If it wasn't for this super chat, I wouldn't have been able to get it. I wouldn't have. And who would have thought nails and extensions would have made it all the way to the fucking federal copyright board? What? These people have my address and now they know I have hair extensions. The nerve, Siwa. Yeah, I am La Rosita. What? Who lies on Good Friday? Thank you, Mona, for the super chat. I appreciate that so much. I mean, y'all are the ones setting this all thing up. I mean, if necessary to prove my point, I can show you where I was like, oh my God, that it was, I think, whose idea was it? If you want to step in front of the congregation and take credit for this, you may. I will never call you out without asking first. But the person that's credited, and I hope you do, because it will also totally debunk what Jules is about to say.
Instead of, because Siwa hasn't gone live. Siwa hasn't gone live in how long, so she has nothing else to do. So she's stealing Cooch's jam, which is fucking hysterical. I cannot wait until that falls apart, because she's literally taking Cooch's content because she doesn't have any. Don't worry, she'll be drunk and make another fool of herself. Oh, I know, that's what we're betting on. We're betting on the drunkenness. But anybody that super chats her tonight, just know that you are being manipulated by her. Just like when her and Tiri Lynn fell out, it was because she went live to try to get super chats up against Siwa. Because that is what that child does.
No, I thought that Tiri Lynn got mad at me because I went live. She had already posted. This is the original version. And like I said earlier, I've talked to Tiri Lynn since then. And she's told me the real reason she got upset about it, which was it Dee did tell us not to talk about Siwa. And she thought I was going against what Dee said. All in regards to the stuff she had going on privately about not talking about Siwa. And Tiri Lynn thought I did it. Even though Dee said not to. This is what I find out later. But what happened initially is that I thought Tiri Lynn was pissed because I went live and she's like, I have a live scheduled. And it just happened that we scheduled our lives and then I went live and just happened. I didn't know I was going to get a bunch of fucking super chats. It just fucking happened. I had to go to work the next day. I did not plan on being long. I was just going to go on to troll Siwa's dumbass. Oh my God, Nurse Jen, thank you. Look what you made me do. I mean, seriously, I had no idea that was going to happen. And in my opinion, because we never really talked about it, Tiri Lynn and I, until after, like recently, pretty recent. So fuck right off. And I'm sure Tiri Lynn, when you were friends with her, told you the fucking story. Because I'm sure you asked, because you're obsessed with me. It was Cooch's idea, bitch.
She's like, this isn't going to be over very well. How is Cooch going to take this? She's covering her. Ooh, she wouldn't like it if people covered Siwa.
It was Cooch's idea.
Our little games don't like your tilted stage. The role you made me play, the fool. No, I don't like you. I don't like your perfect crime. How you laugh when you lie. You said the gun was mine. Isn't cool, no, I don't like you. But I got smarter, I got harder in the nick of time. Honey, I rose up from the dead, I do it all the time. I got a list of names and yours is in red underlined. I check it once, then I check it twice. Oh! Look what you made me do. Look what you made me do. Look what you just made me do. Look what you just made me do. Look what you made me do. Look what you made me do. Look what you just made me do. Look what you just made me do. I don't like your kingdom keys. They once belonged to me. You asked me for a place to sleep. Locked me out and threw a feast. The world moves on another day, another drama, drama. But not for me, not for me. All I think about is karma. And then the world moves on, but one thing's for sure. Maybe I got mine, but you'll all get yours. But I got smarter, I got harder in the nick of time. I rose up from the dead, I do it all the time. I got a list of names and yours is in red underlined. I check it once, then I check it twice. Oh! Look what you made me do. Look what you made me do. Look what you just made me do. Look what you just made me do. Look what you made me do. Look what you made me do. Look what you just made me do. Look what you just made me
do. Remember when Amber did that shit? Remember when she was singing it on John's panel? Do y'all remember that? She's like, John, let me sing it. And she was like, look what you made me do. Look what you made me do. Look what you... It was the fucking cringest. That's why I miss her. I miss that cringe-ass shit that she used to do. Look what you made me do. What the fuck? These people are clowns. Thank you, Cooch, for the super chat again. It was Cooch's idea. B. I can't believe I've broken my sacred promise and not entertaining this. Ugh.
No, Jade, she has fucking nothing. Absolutely zilch. Nothing. All she has is her meanness. There's not one thing she does for anybody. She doesn't do anything for... Hold on, guys. We haven't done a song yet. This is what she wants.
Oh, God.
Here. Dang it. I should have restarted the computer before I started this.
And so I'm not even going to show it. She puts this emoji up of a person with a big belly and it has an A on their belly. And she's like, it's AMZ. Ha! Turn your camera on. You're not allowed to make fun of other people unless you stand up and go do a TikTok dance like AMZ did. Period. She's playing I'm Fat by Weird Al. Jules, stop. You're the one that weighs yourself literally once an hour. I promise. I'm not lying. When she thinks she's losing weight, she goes and weighs like literally fucking a dozen times a day. I shit you not.
That they're going to be a witness in the case. They're mocking them on their birthday. Did we mock her on her birthday? Did we? I don't remember if we did or not. Did we? Because this is what they seem to do. But
yeah, Sudie, it's your fault. It's all your fault, Sudie. It's all, yes, it's Muzz is John's birthday. That's why I got 42 super chats and other things. Because we're celebrating John over here. We are. This is all in the name of John. Happy birthday to ya. Happy birthday to ya. Happy birthday. Happy birthday, John, from me to you. Mwah. But, Sudie, this is all your fault. I'm totally stepping down. Like, hashtag liability. I'm stepping down. I'm giving you my crown of the trigger of the evening. I was just the runner-up. That's all. You started it, Sudie. Cheers!
This is what Brooke does because she needs the Benjamins. She does. She needs the Benjamins. I mean, yeah, the bee and little tiny spice.
Do I need the Benjamins or do you need the Benjamins? Do you or do I? Like, I mean, I think at this point in our, like, with our economy right now, I think everybody could use a little bit of extra money. Like, she is so vicious. Like, this is her money. Like, bitch, these people wouldn't be giving you money no way. Fucking stand down. Retreat.
Little tiny, tiny shots of spice. Yes, if you will. Geneva, hello. Yes, little tiny, tiny shots of spice. Because it's bullshit. It is absolute bullshit. So I wanted to go live and let you guys know that you're free to do whatever you want. You don't need to go and give the eyeball a bunch of money because she's upset. Because, you know, here's the thing is...
She literally tried to stop any fucking revenue that I will make on this stream before hours. How many hours before it even started? What kind of a psycho are you? You're right up there with Geneva, girl. Mm-hmm. I said it.
Make her show content. Maybe make her.
And I ran across it. I don't have permission to use it, nor do I know where it is exactly right now. But a screenshot of you, Jules, sending somebody background checks and talking about said background checks with your voice.
We don't do that over here.
New member emojis that she made with her own self. Maybe do something.
Well, that says more about him. And it's literally only because he's upset that I'm over here on a live. Like, why can't he just be a grown up? He's fucking 45 and do a live stream for his birthday and ignore me. I wasn't even really planning on talking about much except for Geneva tonight. And then this happened. It fell in my lap. You are tripping. I didn't do this. I was literally, I put it on my diary. What I planned on discussing, now it's a big, you know, modge podge of topics, hot topics. Oh, I know. I already know. It's not going to trigger me. How can you trigger me more than once with the same thing? He's just going to end up. Somebody's just going to end up doing what they always do on his birthday live, and it won't be me. Thank you, Glenwood. I appreciate that. Did you try to call out people before about where to send their money? She chased people away. Oh, and you know what else was hilarious tonight? John was like, that fucking puppy lot, that puppy shower was so stupid. That was the stupidest shit. You know who told me to do it, and you see how excited that one Jules gets about shit. Oh, yeah, and yeah, we should. Oh, yeah. It was her and Julie that I had never heard of a fucking puppy shower in my lifetime. I even went and asked my in real life friends, have y'all ever heard of a fucking puppy shower? I was like, I mean, I love animals, but I don't go out and rescue them, and maybe that's the difference, but I have never heard of a puppy shower. And they were like insistent on me having one, and they organized it. So how are you sitting there chastising it when, John, you know for a fact that I'm not the one that even organized that or even knew it existed? Yes, Brooklyn's got all the cash. Can you imagine the people that just bought him a computer, now he's like got another huge expense on his shoulders, and he's like basically like looking at them like, okay, I would be like, oh, my God. And that's kind of how I was when I was friends with him. It was always something. Oh, we broke a stove. We need a fucking stove fund. Oh, I'm like, he's got all those degrees he brandishes. Why, in tough times, doesn't he go and put his big boy pants on and go get a jobby job? Like a real 45-year-old man with no 401k. I don't care. I'm going to strike him. I'll strike him. It will go to the judge. What he's doing actually to a person he knows is a witness. Like, I don't have any... This is not on... behalf of anybody in that case. I can say what I want to because I have my own free will and thoughts about this man because of what he's done to me and what he's doing right now. Another trap that was set and baited that John just fell into on his birthday, y'all. On his birthday. You know it's never a celebration on this channel unless we play this song. It's just not. Song and I shall, Rosita. I shall. I fucking love that song. I can't wait to have this submitted. And there's plenty of time to do it. There's plenty. And I made sure to mark my schedule off clear for that day. So I'll be there for the rescheduling and any future reschedulings. I have a, you know, just anyway, making it rain. Thank you, Gamecock Jenny. Whoop, whoop. I can't believe in retaliation because you're upset about me going live. You throw it a fit first, giving me something to say and defend, and now you're pissed and doing that. Okay, I'm okay. I'd rather play the not live. Sorry. You can't. Gosh, and see when the anger comes, and what a fabulous song. When I play the whole song, y'all know I have not sat down since I started this live, and I have been dancing, just like all y'all's little emojis. Babe, I'm gonna live forever, and you need to just really, you're really looking gross, and I'm gonna show the judge what you're doing to a witness. That is what I would consider. What do they call that in legal terminology? What do they call that guy's class? What is it? Isn't it like, would it be considered tampering? I mean, it's your birthday. Go shorty. I mean, what in the fuck? Why are we having such a foul time over there? I'm so sorry that I made super chats tonight, all because y'all were worried about the super chats I was going to make and I didn't even go live yet. All of you, for a collective like 8-hour workday total, have been worried about money, and everybody's been listening. So what do you think that's doing? I didn't solicit shit. You know who solicited it? You. On your fucking birthday. Congratulations.
We gon' party like it's your birthday. We gon' sip a Bacardi like it's your birthday. And you know we don't give a fuck, cause that's your birthday. You can find me in the club, bottle full of bub. Mama, I got what you need, if you need to fill a buzz. I'm into having sex, I ain't into making love. So come give me a hug, if you're into getting rough. You can find me in the club, bottle full of bub. Mama, I got what you need, if you need to fill a buzz. I'm into having sex, I ain't into making love. So come give me a hug, if you're into getting rough. When I pull up out front, you see the Benz on dub. When I roll 20 deep, it's always drama in the club. Now that I roll with Dre, everybody show me love. When you sell like Eminem, you get plenty of groupie love. Look, homie, ain't nothing changed. Grow down, G's up. I see exhibit in the cutting, man. Bro, you watch how I move. You mistake before I play up here. Been hit with a few, but now I walk with a limp. In the hood, in the lady, they saying 50, you hot. They like me, I want them to love me like they love.
Hold up, I'm going to do what they do. And nobody's saying there's nothing wrong with that. There's nobody in that chat saying to stop. There's nobody in that chat saying this is going too far. I'm going to play your card on you, all of you. There's nobody in that chat saying to stop doing that. Really? Y'all notice I don't ever say this shit. I'm taking it on the motherfucking chin because it says way more about them than it does about me. Like, seriously, you're not going to bother me. Y'all have tried to take my channel, my job, my freedom. You've infiltrated my children's social media and their privacy. Jules insinuates all the time, all kind of private shit about my daughter that she learned when she was a minor. But Jules, I guess, doesn't give a fuck about minors. Like, you know what I'm saying? That's just proving my point. Like, I hate that. like my kids that are now above 18 know that this has happened and know that it's happening. And they're like, yeah, y'all saw how Marley took care of the situation after she was sick and tired of Siwa lurking on our fucking page with her big walrus head picture. It literally looked like that in a text that she sent me. Like when she sent me the text, it was like a little bitty emoji next to the thing. And I'm like, that's for real. Which like, it's just like this big, I don't even know how to explain it. Y'all saw it, I guess.
I don't know, Lisa Dempsey, because maybe she thinks it's charming. I don't know.
But Marley tore that ass up. See what? And to say, yeah, she followed you to mess or make sure she could message with you to see if you were going to message her. And like she told me she should not have messaged me. Like you, she was sick of you looking at her shit. She was like, yo, okay, basically pull up. Come on, old lady. She said you look 60, and that's coming from an 18-year-old. And I know because she called me afterwards, and she told me, I'm like, delete it. Anyways, and she was like, is she like 60? I'm like, no. She's like, oh, well, that's what I said to you. I was like, oh, my God. And anybody that knows I was freaking out. Mm-hmm. I know, E11.
She ruined my birthday.
Sorry. There was a... Oh, Lord. It's just like... I just cannot... Well, Jason just came in and said that I have to get off the stream because I haven't met my quota. So, just kidding. Anyway, but he did just come in, so that's why I muted. Anyway, yeah, she sure did, PMR. Mm-hmm. She sure did. Because what else are you going to do? Like, I did not want that. Like, seriously, I know they don't want to believe that shit. I did. I was tripping balls that... Okay, so I'm seeing that several subs told them to stop. Well, good for you. Thank you. I will verbally give you thanks when I find out who you are that told them to stop. But don't just tell them to stop. Like, stop, unsub, and, like, unfollow. You don't have to come over here. You're welcome, but come, I mean, but certain people are. But just stop. Your people that are in there entertaining it, you know? He called her a bitch, really? Well, it's a shame. Yeah, right? Okay. Well, thanks to those that did tell him to take it down. I appreciate that. I missed the song request, and I'm like, well, at least I'm not going to sit here and cry for an hour and a half about shit. I'm going to move on. Okay. I see. Palette cleanser. Thank you. Reminds me of fucking CYO dances, and I literally remembered Michelle, Tamique, and Tanya gonna ride this train. Like, that is such a good throwback. What a good song! What a great freaking song! Another one that I almost forgot existed until like right now.
Type of effort into your channel instead of just opening up a channel full of hate, which is what it is. And I mean, it's fine. Okay.
I think we have fun over here, actually. And all I do is like laugh at y'all's dumb asses. Like, somebody's got to do it, you know? My God, y'all are ridiculous.
Yeah, like, because people are going to say, oh, Jules, you're not a bunch of rainbows. No, I'm not rainbows today. But I do put effort into it. I make new emojis. I made a new emoji today. You look at my screen, I'm branded.
Good for you. Good for you. Good for you. I don't even have time to tell you what I've done today, much less, I cannot.
With several copywritten images all over it. I hear some folks are super jealous of super chats, so don't.
Some folks are super jealous of super chats. Well, look what you done did. There's 44. 44. And I'm not like you, Jules. I'm not like, yeah, let's get to 100. That's you. The one that really is worried about money. And does she not get that it shows that she's the one that's worried about money by doing a preemptive live about me making money? And then everybody heard it. Everybody heard that she's tripping balls. So, of course.
Don't be jelly, folks. Your hate is shining through.
Yeah, it was in a bullying emoji. Good job. Congrats. I cannot wait for AMZ to tear into you. Quite frankly.
It's ridiculous. It is absolutely ridiculous. But guys, this is why she's live tonight. I did that once to John. Remember when he got pissed off about Sadie and all that stuff? I did the chat extravaganza. I did one. And that was almost 2 years ago now. It was in 2022. This one over here, she has nothing else. And it just kills me. Everybody, oh my goodness, Brooke is a nurse and she works so hard. Well, that's why she gets paid at her work. And she gets paid almost six figures for that. That's what she gets paid for. So maybe base it on what she puts forth on here. Because basically what she's doing is calling
you
guys.
That's funny. I've never told you how much I make. How do you fucking know? And by the way, whatever you're looking up does not include overtime.
And I know Jennifer Negativity, she's going to fall for it hook, line, and sinker. Because
like, when do you get condemned for having a job? Number 45, happy birthday, John. It's all about you tonight.
Elevate scrotum with a towel roll while laying down, which I've been doing. Elevate scrotum with a towel roll while laying down, which I've been doing.
Elevate scrotum with a towel. Elevate scrotum with a towel.
Scrotum, scrotum, scrotum. Scrotum, scrotum, scrotum. Elevate the towel roll while laying down, which I've been doing.
Thank you, Health, Wealth, and Hope. Number 45, just for you, John. I hope you're having a great birthday, even though you quit after you got a brand new computer and things, you know. And then also then doubled down and asked for, you know, passively funds to relocate at a whim's notice. And then his chat actually was like, actually, John, in that state, you have 60 days of vacate notice. So, is that why we're all upset over there? Is that why? Uh-oh. Oh, my gosh. And one to freaking grow on? And one to grow on? Gina Marie, tuh. You shouldn't have. Because that means, you know, that we got another year. Thank you, Gina Marie, so much. Well, I think I'm done. Just kidding. Just kidding. What in the what? Look what you did, B. Look what you did. Look what you made them do. Look what you made them do.
And fuels that woman more than hate.
What? It's you.
So anyway, let's get to this crap, shall we?
47. Thank you.
I don't even know what speed we're going to have here.
So much, Stacey AB, for the super sticker. Look what you made her do. Not me. You, boo-boo. That would be you. My lord. This is kind of...
I don't like your little games. Don't like your...
She was just... a bed of roses, a pocket full of posies, whatever.
Easily, like, I've been sick in bed, coughing my ass off. Like, it's not Ozempic. Thank you, though. I appreciate the concern. Thanks.
Hold on. I have to, because I start doing regular speed, and I have to switch it. Hold on. What the fuck is going on here? Okay, here we go. So she's saying that she is somebody that should actually been taking Ozempic. So, listen to this. Listen to this. This is hysterical. So, okay, first of all, yesterday, people on Reddit gave her a little bit of a hard time about.
Jules, thank you, Sweets and Beyond, for that super chat or super sticker. Thank you so much. Oh, and thank you, Lindsay, for jogging my memory. And thanks again, Sweets. Let me give you a proper walrus thank you. Oh my gosh, and you too, Cats Rule, again, thank you so much. Y'all are freaking awesome. We're at 49. It's 29, but it's 49. Oh my goodness. Nothing. She's fucking jealous that she can't take it. Nurse Jen, that's what's the issue. That's the issue. There's no problem with Sophie taking it, but I take it or Amzy takes it. Oh, it's an issue. Oh, Amzy's lying. How the fuck do you know? Amzy knows that if she's telling people she's taking Ozempic, she's going to have to produce a weight loss in a 3-month, 4-month time frame. Shut the fuck up until you know. Leave her alone. Are you jealous that you don't know of a compounding pharmacy? She lives in a big city. And by the way, Lean In, it's such a thing. Also, there's doctors that also administer it. If it's a clinic, like a weight loss clinic with physicians. And quit saying I took Ozempic. I took Wegovy. It's helping everybody, Nurse Jen. And by the way, they're coming out with a generic of one of them. I can't remember. In June is when they have the Senate hearing, I believe. So I didn't really realize this, that every time a medication goes from brand name to generic, they have to have a whole ass hearing and make it, I guess it's like patent type situations, to make it, you know, which makes total sense, but I guess I never thought about it that far. Make it be able to be marketed as different names and different shapes and colors and blah, blah, blah. Huh. Who knew? But anyway. So it should be much more affordable. coming in June. So everybody, I think it's, I literally think it's like the 22nd of June is the, Google it. I promise. I didn't do this. One of my friends told me this. So passing on scoop. And Manjaro is another good one, Lisa. You know it. And as if, you know, I would have been a real big bitch if I just started like losing weight and didn't tell anybody. And then like way later after the fact when it was like you couldn't get it was like, oh my God, okay, fine. I took Wegovy. No, I told everybody out of the gate. Out of the gate. Because, and I'm sorry, whether you like it or not, I've helped a lot of people. So. Judge on, Judgy B. Oh my gosh, thank you again, Mona. Thanks to B and Flea by the Sea. More nails and more hair extensions. Thank you so much. So much. It is a life and game changer. I mean, just look at Daddy. Hello. Hello. Daddy's wearing whole ass, like, what are those? I can't wear them because I just don't have... She's tall and slender. What are those things called that everybody, all those skinny girls wear? Daddy, what is the, you know, like not the leotards. They're not called leotards. That's what I call them because I danced all my life. What are those things called? No, not romper. She's able to wear jeans and the thing that buttons like a onesie and have a flat stomach and nice. A nice chest. Yes, a bodysuit. Thank you. I'm not of the bodysuit era. Maybe if I get into the gym, maybe. I'll give it one last like jaunt before I'm 45 to literally try to get into the shape. I mean, and I think I was like at that point, like last December, it was pretty small. But still, yeah, I would have to, nothing. Yeah, Spanx or surgery, period for me. Just period. I know that we're, but you're taller. So, but my point is, you among other women that have been in my chat, I've helped. And oh my God, everybody's got such a problem. And good on AMSI. Good on Sophie. Congratulations, ladies. And I hope that more people, and if you want to know who in your area, just Google it. Say, you know, semi-glutide, don't put Ozempic or Wegovy, just put semi-glutide injections, compound pharmacies, however you need to Google it near me in your search engine. And then it should come up with like wellness spas and other places and just do your research and see, ask your doctor if it's cool and then move forward. Everybody is taller than me, ambulance girl. Oh my God. Touche.
Her taking meds, right? Taking the Ozempic. So let me read a little bit. It's reading time, folks.
Aw, E11, thank you.
I have my window open today. It's not completely warm. I was out and about. You know what's really funny for everybody?
Thank you so much, E11, for the super chat. This is number freaking 50, y'all. And I wasn't even like aiming at a goal or some weird shit. This bitch is like counting my pockets before I even go live. Again, I'm going to keep saying it because it needs to be reiterated. This is what this whole bitch fit is about.
Jules never leaves the house. You guys, I leave the house every single day. Just because you guys don't know where I go is none of your business.
No, you don't, or you wouldn't have so much time to have the perfect emojis and the perfect overlays. And thank you again, E11, for the number 50. Wait, I see 51. I fucking love you guys. And it's not because of the super chats. It's because it's just called support. And like, we're not about, like, how dare you talk about E11 and her husband? What the fuck has she done to you? She goes live about microgreens. What the fuck is wrong with you? Yeah, she talks about the community sometimes. And yeah, she made a very educational piece that is like legendary, in my opinion, because it is needed. Aboard like you're in a murder mystery with yarn. Well, post-its. At any rate, it was helpful. You need guidance when you have how many victims? What it was at E11? 90 plus? Oh, thank you, Joe B and Joe. I know, right? She let me get my happy pills. Let me get my smart pills. Let me get my let me hit my whack. Like, stop. Y'all can slander, bash me all you want. And the reason they do, again, lean in, is because they know it. The investment of suing somebody civilly, there has to be assets to be able to freeze or liquidate to be able for it to be worth it. And they know they have John, Jewel, Siwa, they all know they have nothing to liquidate or freeze. Ta-da! But, oh, over here, we have people with jobs and mortgages, 401ks, retirements, 403bs, stocks, shit like that. Like, and you got people over there worrying about everything but them fucking selves, yo. And I'm sorry that she's been making fun of you. She called you Ricky Lake, which to me is a absolute huge compliment. Just like when they call me Barbara Streisand. I'm sorry, every time I say her name, I hear the song. Every time. I won't play much, I promise. But every time. And by the way, talk about originality. I'm going to say it again. The first bitch that ever started playing music and air quote DJing, if you want to call it that, I never did, on my channel was me. Jules only did it after she figured out that I could still keep the super chats and whatnot and play music. So talk about originality, okay? Let's talk about it.
New York is the place of opportunities. If there is any place in this world that you want to come to be able to make it big or to go after your dreams, it is New York City.
Barbara Streisand. Barbara Streisand.
Why, it's John's birthday party. Lita, welcome. Welcome. He shit talked you tonight too, I think, if I'm not mistaken, on his own channel for his own party. They were so concerned. I wasn't even live yet. But anyway, I think you were brought up. But welcome, Lita.
Yo, what up? This is Ella Wolf, Catfish, Billy, kicking on my homie with DJ and Travis. Holla at you, baby. Barbara Streisand.
And also, Cooch, by the way, I'm splitting half of everything I've made tonight on this stream with you before the 30%. I'll send you the receipts and the Cash App after this live. It might be today, it might be tomorrow, but I'm sending you half because it was your idea. That's what you call teamwork. Teamwork makes the dream work because that's what you do. It wasn't my idea. I didn't know this would happen. And I am going to share it with Cooch because she was the mastermind. And she could have done this on her channel. It was her idea. So I'm sharing half with Gucci Buddha. You can say no all you want. I've got your cash app. Boop, boop, be-doop. I miss Amber. Amber, where art thou? Boop, boop, we miss you. Lyerson. I have a question. Is it really true? Could anybody that knows? Oh, and Lita, he talked some major, like he was just trashing E11. Anybody in my chat? He was, who else did he talk about, y'all? All of you guys. You're right. I'm stopping. I'm melting. I really am melting. Is it true that I can go back on John's pathetic birthday live stream and play like the beginning? Are excerpts and not get a strike, or is that not true? And I need everybody to be real fucking sure if they tell me yes or no. Can I play? Like, it was literally an hour. I just need like a couple minutes. It was like they were trying to change the subject. Jules was being a bee. She was going, Lindsay. I shit you not. I'm going, oh, and I'm the one that's a loser on a Friday. You're the one in a fucking bee avatar screaming at Lindsay? Don't risk it. Okay. Yeah, you're right. It's really risky, especially since my channel has zero strikes. See what you lose. You lose. John, you lose. Jules, you lose. You all fucking lose. All of you lose. Period. I mean, they've literally tried to get, for years now, to get my job taken. Like, to go on live stream and put my compliance officer's name, phone number, email address, and call them and blah, blah, blah on a live stream. He's like, what did I even do to her? No, I haven't gotten served. I told y'all she ain't serving me. I've offered free service too. I check my email every day. Losers. Thank you, Gina Marie, for being a member for 6 months or 7 months. Wow.
So it was like, Cooch is going to be really pissed off.
I guess I didn't catch that part, but yeah. But I'm sure Cooch will have no problem covering the entirety of that ridiculous birthday stream. Like, I cannot believe it. Like, that is, like, I'm sorry. I win. I'm going to pat myself on the back. I am. I trolled you, motherfucker. I trolled you, John. I really was literally, oh, which I still have to read before I get off of here, which I'm going to address. Sorry, hold on. Jason's brushing his teeth. One sec. Okay, sorry. I just had to ask for permission to stream. I'm just kidding. So he's actually getting me something. So I was really coming over here to talk about Geneva. I put it in my fucking community tab. I literally did.
Can you bring me to work?
Hold on one second. Yes, I will. Anyway, So, winner, winner, chicken dinner. But let me read this, and let me just say, Geneva, for you to just keep showing your face, it reminds me of all these other people that when they're caught, like, it reminds me of Amber. Like, she'd get caught in all this. Make a channel. Still make a YouTube. She's making a, like, how could you dare show your face around these parts after you've been called out so many times for egregious, provable lies, right? Like, how can you do this? And I feel the same way about Geneva. She was right-hand man. Like, and I know not everybody takes the time to read long, very long, extensive. I know I get anxiety too, and I'm like, I ain't reading that. I get the same way about when people text me, like, really long messages and stuff, like, Jules, you there? Or one after the other, either way, like, for a week without any response at all. I just cannot even believe I lost my total train of thought because I'm reading comments again that you guys are just totally fucking obsessed. Geneva, I can't believe you show your face because you've been called out already. See, it was like, I don't need to see your nursing license. Personally, if I was really close with somebody, like, let's say Daddy, for example. Let's say it came into question that Daddy did not have the credentials that Daddy told me she has. Just using her as an example. And yes, she has credentials. And she also has a luxury car and kids that love her and a mom that loves her too. Hold on 1 second. Once again. Okay, sorry. Anyway, Geneva doesn't have to be, if it were my friend at this point, like, Daddy, I'd be like, look, Daddy, everybody's telling me that you're not what you say or who you say. And even though I've seen pictures of your luxury car and your very nice lifestyle and wardrobe and sense of style, mind you, and you know, summer body and all the things, that make, I think Geneva's in love with you, by the way. Anyway, I digress. Geneva walks around here without having to show a nursing license. And if it were Daddy and it were in question, I'd be like, Daddy, can you just go ahead and just, like, let me see, just, like, between me and you, I'll never say that I asked or that I saw. No. And I'll tell you why. It's because Geneva's nursing license does not exist. Anyway, so real quick, I do need to get off, obviously. let me go to my diary. And again, thank y'all all for being here and for all the freaking love that you've shown. For real. Let me see. Yeah. I'm going to read them from my phone. I'm Sorry, I keep getting sidetracked. Actually, yeah, let me just read them from here. So, by the way, let me preface this by saying that for months, Daddy's been getting spoof calls, and it's every time Geneva's feet get held to the fire. Every time she gets called out by me or anybody else, Daddy starts getting these really weird, I know what you did last summer, or scream or whatever, text messages. They're weird as fuck. Like, I'm talking to your family. Today it was, I'm talking to your kids. They hate you. Your mom that hates you. What do you mean? The screenshots of what? I put them on my community. The ones from, of the texts, absolutely send them. But I'm probably not going to put them up tonight because I really got to get out of here soon. But anyway, so, but let me just run down. I think it serves purpose to say, because like I said, PMR did a great job of running it down, what Geneva's actually done. Oh, and you have a third child that your mother is raising that Daddy didn't know about until today. Good night, sweets. Thank you for being here. And thank you so much. Oh my God. Thank you so much. Love you, Napa, for this another super chat. Happy birthday to you, John. Thank you, Napa. No, Daddy's uterus had no idea. Isn't that nuts? So anyway, here I go. Well, after last night's diatribe of spoof text, I have a few things to say, Miss Jenny. Jenny, get over yourself. I got the retraction I asked for. Sadly, it took a year to receive. The retraction she's speaking of is talking that she posted Christopher in his underwear on Reddit. She blamed PMR for that initially. Thank you again, Napa. Mwah. Okay. Thank you, Jenny, for at least acknowledging it wasn't me who posted Brooke's kid. However, with recent events, I feel the need to address a few things. Why, when I let it be known I am done with this battle, did you decide to use a spoof number to talk shiz and threaten my family again? I brought a third-party mediator into the picture, and you refused to discuss this privately, so here we are. Let's remember, it was you who tried to get AT2 to file charges against John for laying child crimes on him. Your goal was to have John prosecuted. You are lucky I have not done the same so far. Last night, you said you plan to contact my children at their colleges and that you know where their dorms are. Ma'am, you know no boundaries. Yet, you go after Muzz for the same shit you say and that you're guilty of yourself. Or I put yourself in there, sorry. You said that you plan to contact my work again, as well as my spouse's employer. How did that go or work out for you last time? Remember, there was a BOLO, otherwise known as a be on the lookout for, that was sent nationwide to all offices, which we do have picture proof of, literally on a literal building at PMR's job. I've seen it myself with her picture. This is stuff that's been held pretty tight to the vest for a long time. So, remember, a BOLO was sent nationwide to all offices with your face on it, and your IP was traced to your form of payment. You lied and said you had me served. I'm still waiting for service, Siwa, to see what you filed. You lied and you said you had a clearly departed CC served. Dearly departed CC served. Oh, thank you so much. Don't say much. I appreciate the super chat. One more time. Da, 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 da. Yeah, I'm going to read a little bit more. Or I'm going to read this and then we're going to play that song because I love that song. That's like a closing song. Okay. Anyway, thank you so much again. I'm going to leave it up so I remember. Okay. Anyway, a BOLO was sent nationwide to all offices with your face on it. Your IP was traced to your form of payment. You lied and said you had me served, and I'm still waiting for service to see what you filed. You lied and said you had a dearly departed content creator served. This never happened. You, Jenny, admittedly posted said dearly departed content creator's son on Reddit. Why? What was the reason that you would go after an innocent person because you had beef with his mother? You contacted John's best friend while she was in the hospital and ran to chat saying he was lying and she was angry with him. You said he went to visit her to evade the landlord. You kept the rumors going of his eviction. You orchestrated the drive-by of Mod148's home and the FaceTime party to find John and laughed at the condition of Julie's home. Then you lied to her about it. You only admitted to her the truth later because I said I was going to share the truth. You doxed the judge and wanted to take Natalie down for giving John money. Natalie is Kathy. God rest her soul. I miss her every fucking day. And I wear her heart around my neck every day. Literally. Anyway. You contacted the judge's office to tattle on Natalie. Your goal was to cut off your new friend's financial support to cause him further hurt. You stole another woman's identity to pass as your own on YouTube. You can try to make excuses for it, but it was you who changed your profile picture of an innocent woman and claimed her profession as your own. That's why there's no nursing license, by the way. Because she assumed another person's identity. You spread the rumor that John was part of an active investigation by Seaside Heights, which on our end, by the way, he actually was. Like, but that was, that she had nothing to do with that. She was saying it because we were saying it. I'm just adding that in. And how you provided info and have Officer Hershey's cell phone number. You said Seaside won't interfere because they're recording and documenting all of his illegal activity. You hoped in a matter of time, John and Cody were going to be arrested. You rejoiced when the electronics were taken. You found it humorous and spread it around like wildfire. You created a whole ass website with all of John's lives and screenshots for everyone to make videos to cancel him for a year. For a year. And then you lied to John and said it was just for a short period of time. You created IGs and Twitter specifically to spread the petition to cancel John. You used his face with an eyelash filter on it to mock his cross-dressing. You shared Brooke's address, Zillow link, PO number, and work information in retaliation. You were even trying to find out if her work was part of a union. No, that's Callie-ish. You lied and you said that she was on me, desk duty, and that your doctor friend, okay, Siwa, that's actually written. I'm not interjecting that part. Okay, Siwa, called and got all kinds of information about Brooke, all of which was a lie. You got Brooke's arrest record and sent it to her, air quote, enemies, which she had done nothing to you, but sure, attack Muzz for collecting information. You got mad at Jules and sent her mom's obituary out for others to post. Why would you want to hurt her while she's grieving such a freaking loss? Thank you, Canadian girl. Happy birthday to you, John. Thank you for the super chat. Happy birthday, John. Seriously. This is really a lot. You sent an inappropriate package to Maria's home and bragged about it to numerous people. You paid for her court records, posted them, and sent them around unsolicited. Sounds like you, Siwa. No, I did interject that part. Anyway, you called Seaside PD numerous times to have John 5150'd because you thought it was funny that he was caught in a lie and said his attempt was fake. You were going to show... You were going to show him, weren't you? You lied about your friendship with Jolene, This is a big one. You lied about your friendship with Jolene to anyone that would listen. I'm reading a comment left on one of my posts, Lita, from PMR, who was very well in tune and knows everything there is to know about this crazy woman. Anyway, you lied about your friendship with Jolene to anyone who would listen. You were scarily obsessed with her. You lied to a whole new group of friends saying you were in the hospital for treatment, only for them to hear your cat meowing clearly in the background over Discord. Since when do they allow your cats to visit you in the hospital? You lied to me and told me you were in the hospital while I was at work to get my attention. I walked out of a meeting and immediately FaceTimed you, and I found you in your apartment. Hence my anger and the screenshot. Uh-oh, what's going on in my chat? I'm sorry, I'm reading. Anyway. It is unbelievable that you use your health condition to lie to get me to an immediate response. Again, this is PMR writing this on my... This, don't try to spin this or clip it, because it's PMR's words that I'm reading. You went around discussing what you think is my financial situation with others. I now believe it's why your new friend attacked me out of the blue. You know nothing. And now I feel bad for this person because they were used by you and are now struggling mentally. Her words, not mine. You, my dear, are a dishonest shit show. You say you have owned everything you have done, but would you have acknowledged a quarter of it if it wasn't laid out for everyone to see? You have zero common sense or self-control. You lie to cover up lies, as we have seen with you on panel with John Arcewa. And I'm begging you to have your DA niece contact me. It's been nearly a year since you threatened this. Is she still out on FMLA? Does she not have an assistant to contact me? Please, I implore you to have her contact me. Ma'am, you are the cancer in this community. You have been allowed to fester and spread lies through all sides. You have burned everyone who has become close to you, and you attack Muzz for the same exact shit that you do. And I did put exact, because it's you've done worse. You have run out for out of friends, and now you're friends with the man that you claim to despise and you worked so hard to destroy. You have hit rock bottom. These new relationships won't last because you can never behave and you do not know boundaries. You are not, oh, wait, you are who has, you are the biggest mistake in life, telling someone they should have aborted their children, which she told to daddy in the screenshots that will be provided later. Because I'm getting off after this. How could you say that, Geneva? Okay, last line. You are a sick woman in more ways than one, and you can go directly to hell. Signed, Pet My Rock. That is what Geneva has done, that you allow in your chats. It's skin and grin and blah, blah, blah. That's who it is. Anyway, guys, I hate to abruptly end. I'm really approaching sleepy time. I'm so tired. I hope you have had a great night. Thank y'all for coming and celebrating, John. I'm so sorry that he chose violence. We're just over here. Celebrate. Wasn't it well done, Nurse Jen? And that's just like the Cliff's Notes version. That's like, just like, yeah. That's the Reader's Digest version of the whole truth. So don't you lie, Craig. Don't you lie. Again, I cannot thank y'all enough for being here, for my lame ass channel that has zero originality or content, that I suck at running, and all those things. And I really am sorry for being late. I overshot my time. So I really appreciate each and every one of you. And I will see you guys, I promise, much sooner than later. Bye, everybody.